तत्यनुकंपा सुसमीक्षमानं भुञ्जान एव आत्मकृतो विपाकं हिदवाग भूपिभिर्विदधत् नमस्ते जीवेत मुक्तिपदे सदाय भाव तत्यनुकंपा सुसमीक्षमानं भुञ्जान एव आत्मकृतो विपाकं हृद्वाग् भूपिभिर्विदधत् नमस्ते जीवेत मुक्तिपदे सदाय भाव। गौरीय गोष्ठीपति श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल गौरीय गोष्ठीपति श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर जगद्गुरु टोल दैट एनी सिचुएशन यू आर गोइंग टू फेस इन योर लाइफ एनी अमाउंट ऑफ पेनफुल सिचुएशन यू आर गोइंग टू फेस इन योर लाइफ यू शुड थिंक इट that is one kind of blessing by Supreme Lord. Gauriya Goshtipati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, any kind of situation you are meeting in your life, any kind of painful experience you are getting in your life, you should think always that this is one kind of blessing by Supreme Lord. According to my karma fal, it is one kind of blessing. Because Supreme Lord is always Mangalmay. Supreme Lord is the source of all Mangal. Apparently, if you are going to think that it is not the mercy of Supreme Lord, then it is totally wrong Siddhanta. Supreme Lord is always Mangalmay. Anything happening in my life, anything happening in my life, whatever, you should accept it as the blessing of Supreme Lord. Directly or indirectly, you have to feel. You will have to feel that except Advaita Gyanatattva, Supreme Lord, there is nothing. Except Advaita Gyanatattva, there is nothing. This feeling of diversity going to put you in trouble, this dual conception going to, you know, put you in trouble. That's why in some Bhagavad Mahapuran always, you know, we know, bhayam ditiyo vinaveshataha sat ishat apetasya viparajaya sriti tanmayaya ato avayatvam bhaktaik esham gurudeva tatma. So, tatyanukampa, you will have to feel. Any kind of thing happening in your life, all for good, not for bad, everything you will have to feel from your life, in your life. It is actually, those who are actually trying their best to get realization, I mean those who are interested to run in the way of only Gyanmarg, our Vaishnava Siddhanta, actually Achinta Vedavet Tattva, though I am speaking about Advaita Gyanatattva, but still diversity in unity, unity in diversity we should feel. That is our feeling. But those Mayavadi, they are not going to feel that way. They are going to pass this kind of remark that except Advaita Gyanatattva, there is nothing, even no Maya, nothing. They are not going to accept anything. Shakti Tattva also they are going to avoid. Their Brahma Tattva is without Shakti, impersonal Brahma, they are feeling. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur used to give one nice example to give us a direct feeling of what about Bhakti Tattva. Prabhupada used to speak that you can try to realize this point. When a monkey going to catch, when a monkey mother going to jump from here to there, this way jumping from one place to another place, then it is usually we can see that the baby monkey going to catch mother. When mother monkey going to love from one place to another place, then there is no responsibility of mother. There is no responsibility of mother. If the baby going to fall down and going to die, then mother is not responsible. Many such cases happening. Prabhupada giving this example. This is the example of Ganmarg. And another example Prabhupada giving, cat mother going to give birth to a small, baby cat. Then mother going to catch the baby cat with teeth, going to transfer from one place to another place, this way transferring. Apparently we can think that mother going to catch with teeth, then the baby cat must be feeling some pain. No, not that. So going to transfer the baby from one place to another, then the total responsibility is lying with mother. This way Prabhupada used to explain this point. Those who are going to feel that we are Brahma in the way of Ganmarg, they ultimately want to prove that we are Brahma. Aham Brahma Asmi. This is the procedure. This is Gan. This Ganmarg is contaminated. It's very dangerous. This Ganmarg is contaminated. We are less interested about it. And Ganmishra Bhakti, I was speaking about Ganmishra Bhakti, etc. In Ganmishra Bhakti, there is mixing of bhakti. But Mayavadis, those who are Mayavadis, their marg is devoid of bhakti, no touch of bhakti at all. I was also speaking yesterday that it is also one kind of Maya. Maya explanation I was explaining from Nava Yogendra's discussion. And actually, Nimi Maharaj asking that how to cut Maya easily. I wanted to hear all in details about how to cut this Maya. Jataitam maishwaring mayam dustaram akritatmabhi taranti anjaha sthulodhiyo maharso idamuchyatam. We are actually blockheaded, we are material blind, we cannot realize. So you will have to speak out, you will have to advise us so that we can cut this Maya very easily. You will have to advise us so that we can cut this Maya and go out of Maya this way. Then after that, we get explanation that Bhagavad Dharma is the Tatro Bhagavatana Dharmano Sikshet Guruvatma Devataha amayaya unavritva jvestu shed atma atmado harihi. I already discussed. So you have to follow Bhagavad Dharma, exact Bhagavad Dharma. You have to learn from such a Gurudev who is Sadguru and in glory who is non-different from Supreme Lord. Shakshad haritena samasya sakshai rukta sata bhavati vajadvi kintu bhavarja priyavatasya bande guru su charanari. This kind of guru, you will have to follow him who is always engaged in Bhagavad Seva, and he can inculcate the mood of bhakti inside your heart. Bhakta sanjayata bhakti. No reason for why my Gurudev is doing seva. Only the answer is that I am doing bhakti because I like to get more bhakti. Bhakta sanjayata bhakta. I am doing bhakti because I like to get more bhakti. There is no reason behind this bhakti. Bhakti, total nirapeksha, total neutral. Bhakti is never influenced by karma, gyan, nothing. Karma, gyan, karma or gyan has nothing to do with bhakti. It's just totally separate. Bhakti is totally separate. And actually, bhakti is a natural function of soul. But when we know somebody going to do bhakti with some contamination of karma, it is for karma misra bhakti, it is not actually bhakti. When somebody going to do jnana misra bhakti, it is also not pure bhakti, nothing. It is not actually pure bhakti, but they are doing bhakti. Somehow bhakti is contaminated. Bhakti is mixed. That's why we can say it is bhakti. Arav Siddha Bhakti Adi, you must understand first. Then you can realize why I am speaking this way. Bhakti, three types of bhakti usually you can find. Different devotees can show their different bhakti mode. Countless devotees, they can show bhakti in different way. But basically, we can divide bhakti into three different categories. One is Arab Siddha Bhakti. Arab means attributed. It is not actually bhakti, it is attributed. This name bhakti is attributed. So it is Arav Siddha Bhakti. And another we can say Sangha Siddha Bhakti. And another is Sarup Siddha. So three different categories we can find in the way of devotion. Not that everybody doing pure bhakti, showing people pure bhakti, not that. So Arav Siddha Bhakti attributed, it is not actually bhakti. Sangha Siddha Bhakti with the association of karma gyan, when it is going to show such a mood that as if bhakti, almost bhakti, it is like bhakti, then it is Sangha Siddha Bhakti. It is not Sarupata Bhakti, by Sarup it is not actually. And when Sarup Siddha Bhakti is a Sarup Siddha Bhakti mean, by Sarup it is itself Bhakti. There is no contamination, nothing. So, which is not actually by Sarup, not Bhakti, but it is attributed, it is like bhakti. It is like bhakti actually. Then it is called aropito hai, it is attributed. It is like bhakti. Then it is called arop siddha bhakti. Ar Sarupata, if it is not actually Sarupata Bhakti, then it is not actually Bhakti. When Bhakti is contaminated with by the association of karma, jnana, karmanga, bhuto, vairagya, anga, bhuto, jnanango, karmanga, bhuto, vairagya, badanadi, different kind of, you know, vairagya, detachment or different kind of dan, donation, etc. If it is mixed with bhakti, little bit bhakti, then it is Sangha Siddha Bhakti. It is called actually Sangha Siddha Bhakti. When actually Bhagavad, Naam, Gun, Leela, Parikar, Vaishishta, Smaran, Shravan, Kirtan, Smaran, Itamana, actually it is called, when it is coming genuinely from heart, then it is called Sarusiddha Sarupada Bhakti. When automatically, spontaneously, the glories of Supreme Lord, Naam, Gun, Leela, or Leela, Savan, Kirtan, Smaran, Mananadi, everything going on continuously from heart, then it is called Sarup Siddha Bhakti Ba Sarupate. By Sarup it is Bhakti. Sarup Siddha Bhakti in Siddha Avastha of a devotee. Sarup Shabda Sarup Siddha Bhakti is there. A Sarup Siddha Bhakti in Siddha Avastha, it is also there. Varnasam Dharma Arup Siddha Bhakti Matro. Varnasam Dharma, it is one kind of Arup Siddha Bhakti. Bhakti, but Arup Siddha Bhakti. Varnasam, because if their target is not to satisfy Supreme Lord, then is a big problem. Not by Sarup, it is not actually Bhakti. By Sarup, it is not actually Bhakti. So, big problem can be. It is not a matter of joke, the sloka I started with. Tattayanikampa susamikshamanam bhunjano eva. It is not a matter of joke. To recite this sloka is very easy. To recite this sloka is very easy, but to follow this procedure, to get this kind of bhav exactly inside heart, almost impossible. Anything happening in my life, it is for good. Tulla ninda stuti mouni santushta jena kena chita aniketa sthir matir bhakti maam netya nara. A man, somebody going to insult, somebody going to give big honor. Only with pure Vaishnava you can find this kind of thing. They never care if somebody is going to insult, somebody is going to give honor. They are never going to get contaminated by this kind of thing, external thing. So Tatte Anukamban Susamikshamam, always you will have to feel, realize, whatever thing happening, it is my previous karma. I have done something previously and I am going to get this kind of karma fall. Taptyanu susamikshama. Susamikshaman means with positive mood. Susamikshaman, samikshaman is survey. Samiksha is Bengali word and Sanskrit word. And Hindi also we can speak. Samiksha means survey. Shu samikshamanam means very analytically with positive mood you will have to with positive mood you will have to analytically think out. You'll have to think out. It is called Tattamika Susamikshaman. Bhunjan Eva Atmakitabeva Atmakitamabhar. What all Dhruva Maharaj in front of small Dhruva Maharaj. Very small Dhruva Maharaj, 5 years, mother going to speak. Mother going to speak, my son, don't like to find fault with others. Don't like to find fault with others. All jivas, they are going to get their result of their previous karma fall. So your stepmother going to insult you, not going to allow you to sit in the lap of king, and I mean in the throne. So it may be it is your karma fall, and my karma fall is also bad, because otherwise why king going to leave me in a solitary place in forest, you know? Maybe I have done some bad, that's why. So you try to get consolation. Don't try to find fault with others. But one thing I can speak to you, anything you like to get in your life, why you are crying? When man crying, when some dissatisfaction coming inside heart. We can find all those gopikas, they are also crying. Madhavindu Uribad crying. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu crying. But this kind of crying is transcendental thing. Aprakito viraha. Aprakito chinmay viraha tatta. They are feeling separation from Supreme Lord. This is not negative, this is positive. If you can cry for Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, then be sure it is positive tattva, it is going to help you to go ahead in your bhajan. But if you are going to cry for your daughter, for your son, for the money loss, for in your life some money loss is there, if you are going to cry, it is also separation, you know. But this kind of separation going to arrange double bondage for you. It's going to arrange double bondage for you. So, tattyanugamman susamikshamanam bhunyan eva atmukhita vipakam ridbhag bapuvir vidad. One vital point here, ridbhag bapuvir vidadad namaste. Ridbhag bapuvir means rid, heart, by, you know, body, mind, and, you know, ridbhag bapuvir. Kai man bakya. Kai mana body, man mana mind, heart, because there is synonym, there is so many meaning. Mahaprabhu, when discussing the Atma Ramascha Munayo Nirgantha Pyurukrame Kuravanti Ahetukim Bhakti Itam Mutukunam Hari Gunaha Hari, this sloka when Mahaprabhu explaining, then we can find Mahaprabhu one by one, each word. Atma. What do you mean by Atma? There are so many different meaning of Atma. Atma Ram. What do you mean by Ram? Atma Ramascha Munayo. Munayo mean, what do you mean by Munayo? Nirgantya. All each word Mahaprabhu is going to explain in all different way and try to apply this formula to prove there are all different kind of meaning coming. All different way. So I say it is one kind of jugglery, but for Mahaprabhu it is not there. A different way you can prove this meaning can coming. Different meaning you can derive, you can get different meaning. Bhattatyanukam susamikshamanam bhunyana eva atmakrita vipakam hridbhag babuvir mean kaya man bakya. Kaya mani body, speech and mind. So, by body, speech or mind, if we are going to surrender by body, speech or mind, you know, if you are going to show your surrender unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, our Guru Vaishnava, first of all Guru Vaishnava, because directly you cannot prove your, directly you cannot show your surrender to teacher unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. You have to go via Guru Vaishnava. Bunjanu eva atmakita vipagam ridbab bubuvir vidadad namaste. And by body, speech of mind, going to show submission, vidadad namaste mean, namaste mean pranam. Namaste mean pranam. By body, speech of mind, dandavat pranam, you see na? So, this namo shabdo, Prabhupada going to explain, Krishnadas Kavita Goswami is right, no mean no. Ma mean false ego, they are already inside your mind, false ego. So Vidadat Namaste, Vidadat Mane, you are going to pay Dandavat. Vidadat Namaste. And actually, namaste means actually you have to throw all your false ego totally. Actually, dandavat pranam, this means whenever we are going to pay dandavat in front of Supreme Lord or Guru Vaishnava, it's surely going to show us that this should be the actual meaning. But usually, we are not going to do. We are paying dandavat, but we are not going to show 100% submission unto lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. Ridbhag Bhapavir Vidadat Namaste Jiveto. This procedure, after full submission unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, when somebody is going to live, somebody is going to lead his life, somebody going to lead his life, then it is very good. Then it is very good. Jibeto mukti padesho dhaiva. Who is expecting to get free of this material clutcher? Jibeto mukti padesho dhaiva. He can get free easily. But when discussion taking place between Sriman Mahaprabhu and Sarvam Bhattacharya, when discussion, when in front of Mahaprabhu, Sarvam Bhattacharya going to change one word from this sloka. What is the sloka? Na jiveto mukti pade. It is originally written in Bhagavatam, jiveto mukti pade. But Sarvam Bhattacharya is going to change one jiveto bhakti pade. Mahaprabhu is going to speak, why you are going to change the word of this Sarvam Bhattacharya in front of Sarvam Bhattacharya, Mahaprabhu speaking. Why you are going to change this word? It is originally written that jiveto mukti pade sadaiva tatte anukampam susamikshamam. Bhunjana eva atmakita vipakam ridbhag bhapavir vidadat namaste jiveto mukti pade sadaiva. Who is going to lead his life this way with full submission under the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan? Surely he is going to get free from material clutcher. No question of failure. Jiveto mukti pade sadaiva. Mahaprabhu speaking, why you are going to change this word? You should not change. Sarvam Bhattacharya speaking, well, I cannot speak this word, mukti pade. I was getting pain for long time because I was mayavadi, always brahma, mukti, this kind of thing always used to think and describe in front of disciple, useless. Like a fox all day and night I was busy with this rubbish philosophy, dry philosophy, you know, Brahma, Mukti, Jeev, you know, this kind of, you know, I was busy with describing all these things, but now, by your mercy, I am feeling so pain when I remember my past life. Even I cannot utter this name Mukti, it's not possible for me. Mahaprabhu speaking, why? If you can explain this, Bale, Mukti is what I cannot speak. Enough of it. So, Jibeto Bhakti Pade Shadaibhak, Mahaprabhu speaking, if you can explain this way, then Mukti is what not going to make any problem for you. But how, as per Sandhi, Samas, it is not Sandhi, it is Samas. You know, how to join sound, how to expound this way, no? This from Sanskrit grammar it is written. So Mahaprabhu going to explain that Mukti Jar Padesh, his Mukti Path. If you are going to explain this way, then there is no problem. Then you cannot feel any pain. Mukti Jar Pade Avasthito. Mukti is situated unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. So if you can explain this way, Mukti is situated unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. So I am going to speak Mukti Pade. Mukti Jar Pade. Mukti is situated unto the lotus feet of that Supreme Lord. That's why I am speaking Mukti Pade. Sarvamurti ji said, no, still I am going to feel pain to speak this Mukti, this word. I don't like to hear again this Mukti. Mahaprabhu was very happy. Usually Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran is non-different from Krishna. Krishna Parivartito. Sukhdev Goswami is speaking, Shakshat Krishna Evahi, no other than Krishna. So we have no right to change any word, dot, full stop, semicolon, nothing. We have no right to change. But why that Parapara Akhileshwar, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu not become angry? Because it is the question of bhakti. Now Sarvamartajajos, his heart is full of devotion. That's why Mahaprabhu approve it. There's no problem. Because anyway, the meaning is very sweet. When Mahaprabhu speaking, Mukti Jarpade, if you can think this way, that Mukti is situated under the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. That's why you are speaking Mukti Pade. Sarvamartajan, no, still I cannot because I am feeling pain. This is very good symptom, Mahaprabhu enjoying. Now Sarvamartajajo changing his heart. So Mahaprabhu is very happy. In this case, Mahaprabhu has not become angry. Though he is going to change one word. Another example I already told long before. When one devotee going to change the slok, Trinadu Visanujana Taro Ribo Saishnina, it was written originally. Taro Ribo Mani, it is like tree. A Vaishnava should grow his patience, enduring power like a tree. But that devotee, he was going to change his word. He wrote that Atyandiya Das Adhikari who compiled Gauriya Kantraha. Prabhupada give this name. Prabhupada was bound to give the name of the book as Gauriya Kantahar. Kantahar means, Kantamar means the necklace. It is a chain, you know, golden chain in your, with locket, there in your neck. It is decorating. So Prabhupada giving this name, Gauriya Kantahar. This book should be named Gauriya Kantahar. For Gauriya, Prabhupada write on small note, speaking, you are going to give this book for the benefit of all countless devotees of Gauriya devotees, you are going to make this book as a necklace, you know, and you are going to offer to all devotees on their neck. This way, Prabhupada was very happy. But there was some complaint with this changing. There was some heavy complaint with this changing. But why he is going to change the original word? That Trinath Visanujana Toro Ropi, Toro Ribo. Ribo means it's just like tree. But he is changing this word and writing Toro Ropi, more than a tree. Then Prabhupada was very satisfied. They wanted to change his word. Prabhupada said, no, it is true. He has written this word out of his own realization, practical realization. A Vaishnava, his enduring power, tolerance is more than a tree. Like Haridas Thakur, I have already given example before. Now you understand why I started with this sloka, tatya nukamba susamikshamana, bunjan eva atmakita vipakam, Ridbhag Bhapavir Vidadat Namaste Jivato Mukti Pade Sha Daiva. Jiveto Bhakti Pade Sha Daiva. Even Bhagavan going to speak, even Bhagavan in Gita speaking, Opi Chet Sudurachara Bhajate Mam Ananya Bhag Sadureva Samantabhya Sammak Vyavasito Hisha. Vishwanath Chakravarti is going to give explanation of this sloka. Some other people, they are going to take undue advantage of this sloka. They are going to point out that Prabhu already write, Opichet Sudurachara. Though they are going to make so much, you know, Durachara, all wrong activities actually, sinful. Opichet Sudurachara. Bhajate Mamananya Bhag. But provided he is going to do Ananya Bhag, then only and only he is going to, you know, do Bhajate Mahi, going to serve me only, not any other demigods, nothing. Opichet Sudurachara Bhajate Mamanan Mam Ananya Bhag Sadureva Samantabhyo Sammak Vyavasito Hisa. Though he is at present doing all rubbish activities, but still, he is going to do my bhajan Ananya Bhag, Bhajate Mam Ananya Bhag. Only and only he is going to worship me. And that's why, because his brain is well organized now, one is going to one direction, due to his previous dirty sanskar, he is bound to do it. Due to his previous dirty sanskar, he is going to do it, what to do. But anyway, he is going to do it, but anyway, he don't like to do it, but somehow. You can remember that Arjun, when putting question in front of Krishna, who is going to compel a jivatma to commit apraha? Who is going to, you know, anichchannopi varseyo baladipa niyajitaha. Anichchannopi varseyo baladipa niyajitaha. As if somebody going to put, somebody going to engage that jivatma into this kind of sinful activity. Anichchannopi varseyo baladipa niyajitaha. Then that explanation, it was beginning, but I am going to discuss a higher thing actually now. There actually we can see that Bhagavan giving an answer, Kam Esho Krodh Esho Rajo Guno Samad Bhavaha Mahasana Mahapapna Vidhinam Enam Vyairina. It is your enemy who is going to put you in trouble. And here in this sloka, Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking, Opichet Sudurachara doesn't mean that he can go on doing all rubbish activities, sinful activities for whole life. Not that. Opijet Sudracharo means he is trying to get free from this kind of previous sanskar. Also, Bhagavan going to show us his own commitment. Vikarma jachot patitam kathanchit dhunoti sarvam hidisam niveshto. Bhagavan speaking, if they are going to at all going to do my bhajan, somehow, knowing the unknowing, somehow, something wrong going to happen in their life. Still, they need not suffer for that. They need not go for expiation, nothing. I am there, I am there sitting inside their heart. I am going to clean their heart. Because I am sitting inside their heart. It is my responsibility. Opichet sudracharo bhajate mamannabhag mam anannabhag sadureva sambandabho sammak vyavasito hisha. His intellect is well organized now. He don't like to do any bad thing, but somehow because of previous sanskar something done, but he need not go for expiation. I can change his heart, no problem. This is the commitment of Supreme Lord already there. So now, actually I was discussing the point that the condition of bonded soul is very dangerous, very, very dangerous. Somehow, if they can try to do bhajan, due to this bonded condition, fluctuation, you know, there is an up and down, different kind of feeling coming. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Bhad in his Madhurya Kadambini writing, different kind of layers are there, and as per the advice of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, jivas, they can go on cleaning their heart, Chaita Darpana Marjanam. But there is different kind of layer, Chaitanya, there is different kind of layer, Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking, dust layer, you know, clay layer, kardam layer, clay layer, you know, this way different kind of layer explained, you can get detailed information from Vishwanath Chakravarti Bhad. You know, iron layer, stone layer, iron layer, you know, then after that bajro layer. So this way, Prabhupada speaking, we will have to charge the dynamite of Harikatha. We will have to charge the dynamite of Harikatha continuously, so that those bonded soul can get the scope to clean their heart, and they can start Hari Bhajan actually. In anarthagastha avastha, when jivatma is full of anartha, in that case they can try their best. But not that with anartha a jiva can do bhakti. In anarthagrastha condition, when he is full of anartha, in that case he can try. He can try, but it is not actual bhakti. So I was explaining step by step different kind of, you know, mode of bhakti, sadhantatta sarup, as was explained by Rai Ramananda, and also Prabhupada was speaking clearly. Inside the heart of a jivatma, the baddha avastha, baddha mukta avastha is already there inside them. I already explained yesterday that in the sarupa of jiva there is both. There is, you know, svabhave, there is both. So it is quite natural they can forget Supreme Lord. By the influence of Maya, sometimes they can forget Him. That's why Abhisruti Krishna Padaravinda Yor Khinoti Avadram Chasantanoti Satasya Suddhim paramatma bhaktim gyananch virago gyananch virago gyananch bhaktim gyananch bhaktim virago yuktam. So actually avisruti krishna padarvindayor khinoti abhadrani cha santanati. When jivatma under the guidance of Guru Vaishnava always try to keep in mind, keep in mind, keep in mind what? The link of Supreme Lord. Abhisruti, abhisruti means no abhisruti. There, if he, if Jivatma somehow going to forget, the moment Jivatma going to forget Supreme Lord, within this gapping, Maya can enter and overpower your feeling, everything. So actually, Abhisruti Krishna Padaravindayor Khinoti Abhadrani. When you are going to, you are trying to remember the lotus feet of Supreme Lord all the time, non-stop, then Khinoti, it is going to Khinoti Abhadrani. Abhadrani, all different kind of anartha, everything, you know, then automatically going to be cleaned up. Khinotya avadrani cha sang tanoti. Sang mean mangal. Sang mean mangal. Sang tanoti. Tanoti mean propagating. In that case, mangal going to get propagated inside your heart. So avisriti krishna padaravindayor khinotya avadradi cha sang tanoti. Shato Sasudin, your heart going to be clean and Shuddha Shato going to cover up your heart. Shato Sasudin, Parvata Bhaktim, Gyanancho Virago, Gyanancho, Gyanancho Vigyano, Virago Yuktam. Sorry, I'm trying to forget. Virago Yuktam, Gyan, Vigyan, and virag mane, virag mane, virag mane detachment. Virag, this word we can explain both way. One is vigato rag, I mean detachment. Vigato rag mean you are already, you are going to, you are going to develop detachment for material thing. And another way we can explain virag mane vishesh rag, this means special attachment to Supreme Lord. Same thing. Meaning is almost same. When you are going to develop special attachment to Supreme Lord, virag, then automatically matters going to leave you. Bhakti pareshanubha virakti ranatra chaishatri ko ek kalaha prapadamanasho. This sloka I explained. So this way it is automatically coming. Bhakti is neutral. Bhakti not going to take help of any Gyan Vairagya, nothing. Bhakti is about Gyan Vairagya, they are bound to take the help of Bhakti. If they are not going to take the help of Bhakti, anyway, they cannot come out successful. Also, yesterday I was going to explain you that Mahat, you know, those who are going to do bhajan of Krishna, they are Mahat Padavacho. They are actually Mahat, but somehow they like to do bhajan of Krishna. You know. Somehow they like to do bhajan of Krishna, that's why they, Sadhva Sadhu, Sadhugan, they can be categorized in the sweeper, you know, Sad Sadhav, you know, Kormi, Yogi, or Bhakto, thin. After that Bhakto, I already discussed yesterday. Sat bhakto sattaro positive comparative superlative. Sat bhakto, who is sat bhakto, and sattaro more superior than sat bhakto. What is the condition? What is the, you know, sattaro bhakto and sattamo bhakto. Three different kind of category. Sat bhakto, who is sat bhakto, who? Somehow I already told that anyhow they are going to do bhajan of Krishna somehow. Somehow they are going to try to do bhajan. So gradually they can get chance. So here sadbhakta means who is having 1 pointed, you know, his mood is 1 point. You know, Vishnu Bhakti Ananya Buddhi Yukto. But still today he cannot avoid fully. Still today, fully he is not out of papa, papa pabritti. Not that he is doing, he is going to do papa. Just now I explained, na? Opiche sudracharo, you know, bhajate mamannabhav. I mean, he is here in sadbhakti, he is not sudracha. Like in the Gita, I already explained, opiche sudracharo. He is sudracha, doing all rubbish activities. But still, when he is going to do my bhajan only, then because you can speak that he is sadhu, because today or tomorrow he is going to get established in bhajan. No problem. But here, point is that only, I know, it is written that pap prabhiti, there is no tendency. You know, he cannot avoid the tendency of papa still today. He is doing bhajan of Krishna only, ananya buddhi yukto. He has taken decision to do bhajan of Krishna only. He has taken decision to do bhajan of Krishna or Vishnu only. But still today, he cannot avoid this is the tendency of papa. But anyway, he is going to feel detachment. He is going to avoid varna sramadi. It's very good. Anyway, his tendency of papa little bit there. But still, he is not going to feel any attachment for varna samdharma. He is not at all attracted by varnasam. He is going to nishthasunno. He has no attachment. For varnasam dharmadi, no attachment. This is the condition of sadbhakta. Sattara bhakta vishnupati ananya bhavjukta. Sattara bhakta is a positive comparative. Sattara bhakta who is little bit higher position, little bit in a higher position. Sattama bhakta is having attachment for Vishnu Charan. Vishnu is going to do bhajan of Vishnu only. And totally saranagata, purna saranagati udaya vayache. He can find, you can find total saranagata, bhav. He is having total saranagati bhav inside your heart. But all 27 different kind of tatastha lakshan partially present there, not fully. All 27 different kind of symptoms I already discussed before. All 27 tatastha lakshan anshik vidyaman, meaning not fully, partially it is present there. Partially present there is called actually is also in the category of sarva dharmanam pratyajamame kansaranam. So he also can deserve full protection from Supreme Lord. Aham tam sarva papibya moksha ishyami masu. But all 27 different kind of tatastha lakshan not fully present there. And Sattama Bhakta Vishnupati Vaikantik Bhavjukto is totally surrendered unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, has full attachment for lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Sattara Bhakta, I already explained. I already explained, Sattaro is having ananya bhav, he is going to do bhajan of Vishnu only. But there is tendency of papa. there is no tendency of any papa inside there. There is sattaro. I jump actually. Sattaro first we first time I must speak sattaro. Sattaro means Vishnu Buddha is going prabritti. There is tendency of papa, not yet clean. It is sattaro. And sattaro means 27 different kind of tatastalakshan partially vidyaman there, but it is totally saranagata is there. Totally, total saranagata unto the lotus feet of Vishnu. Bhagavatam. So now sattama very shortly going to get all the qualities, 27 qualities very shortly is going to get. There is no doubt in it. So this way Raya Ramananda from Gita, in support of this Siddhanta, Raya Ramananda giving this Gita, Sarva Dharmanam Paritaje, etc. This I already explained yesterday all about this. Now I was speaking about Gyanamishra Bhakti, and because Gyanamishra Bhakti always Saddhosar, Mahaprabhu admitted it is Saddhosar, you know, Raya Ramananda speaking, but still Mahaprabhu speaking, it is also external. I already explained yesterday, Gyanamishra Bhakti, and example giving from Gita, given by Raya Ramananda was Brahma Bhuta Prasanyatma Na Sachati Na Kankati Samaha Sarvesha Bhuteshu Madhvaktiṃ Lavate Param. Brahma Bhuto Prasanyatma means he is Brahma Bhuto. Brahma Bhuto, now his heart is busy with impersonal, he is feeling the Brahmananda. He is getting the enjoyment of Brahma. And Rupa Goswami Pada already declared, Yad Brahma Sakshat Kritanishayapi Vinasamayati Vinana Bhogai Apaita Namas Puranena Tatte Parabdha Karmeti Virotu Vedaha. I can explain someday. Brahma Bhuta means he is getting Brahmananda. But not that he is going to hate the Sarupa of Bhagavan. And not that, you know, Gyanamishra Bhakta is not going to avoid totally the Sarupa of Bhagavan. Not that. And Keval Gyan means those who are Mayavadi, they are going to ignore. And this Brahma Bhuta Prasannata, not that he is going to hate, that I cannot, but at present he is in this mood, Brahma Bhuta, he is getting Brahmananda, and he is Prasannyatma, always happy because he has no demand for any material thing, no deserve, no demand, nothing, and he is expressing equal vow, Samabuddhi, Sarva Bhute, because he is Brahmananda, he is feeling everything Brahmamaya, he is feeling. Then he can get Parabhakti, Samaha Sarveshu Bhuteshu, Madhbhakti Mlavate Param. Not that at present he is having Bhakti. By the association of some devotee, he is likely to get Bhakti, he can get Bhakti. Madhbhakti Mlavate Param. Parabhakti he can love, he can get. Gyanmarga sadhan, the bhajan in the marg, in the way of Gyan, is to target that nirvishesh Brahma, anubhav yukta. Atat, there is no name, fame, no qualities and leela, everything is not going to think. Bhumananda, Bhumapurush, you know. Brahmananda he is going to get. He is going to, you know, get in connection with that, you know, Brahmananda. And he has no feeling of any matter, pain and pleasure, nothing. Pain or pleasure, nothing. No, he is devoid of this kind. He is because Brahma Bhuta Prasannyatma. That's why he is not having this kind of feeling. He has no pain and pleasure, feel. তুল্য নিন্দা শ্রুতি মৌনি সন্তুষ্ট যেন কেন চিত অনিকেত শ্রীমদিম ভক্তিমাম মে প্রিয় নরা। Different kind of painful situation can come, you know, he is going to avoid it, not going to touch. But this kind of gyan mark can be divided into two parts. One is Savishesh Paragyani, one is Nirvishesh Paragyani. One is with Savishesh Bhav Gyani, another is Nirvishesh Bhav Gyani. So surely Gyan Mishra Bhakti is Savishesh Paragyani. They are not going to ignore totally. Nirvishesh Paragyani, Savishesh Gyani, by the association of pure devotee, when they are going to get the chance to hear different kind of qualities of Supreme Lord, excellent qualities and beauties of Supreme Lord, then they can change their heart. They can start. They are going to believe the Sachidananda Sarup of Supreme Lord. Like Balaji Maharaj, not going to ignore the Bhagavad Sarup, but he is, this bhajan style is like that. He is going to meditate on the Brahma Vastu, and in the sunrise, when sunrise, he is going to concern his mind that in sunlight he can see, you know, feel his, you know, this way. Savishesh Paragyani, Bharat Maharaj, his bhajan is Gyan Mishra Bhakti. You know, and that devotee, I already explained that he was Karma Mishra Bhakti. I already explained 10 days, maybe 7-10 days before. You know. So those Chatusvam, they are going to change their heart. Sukadev Goswami also going to change his heart. Navajagandra also, previously they were interested to get Brahmananda. Chatusvam also, when they by the mercy, when they heard something from Brahma, they got inspiration. When they were approaching, you know, Vaikuntha, they're trying. In that case, by the smell of Tulsi, Chandan and flower, everything, we already offered unto the lotus feet of Krishna, they are going to get the smell, they are going to change their heart. They are going to change their Shankshobam Asur Aksharajusam Upi Chitta Tono. Though previously they used to do bhajan of Ekakshar Brahma Mantra, Brahma Vastu, but still, when they are going to smell the scent of flowers and chandan already offered unto the lotus feet of Vishnu, Narayan, their feeling changed, their heart. Navajagandha also, Sukhdev Goswami also, when by the desire of Vyasadeva Goswami, some of his disciples going to recite the sloka, selected slokas from Bhagavad-gita Mahapurana, then he was feeling attraction. His Brahmananda was finished. Barha Pira Natavara Vapu Karnayo Karnikaram, this sloka, you know. This sloka and another other slokas are there. So Chatusvam, Navajagandra, Sukhdeva Adi, they are Savishesh Gyani. They are going to get bhakti unmadde. They already got inspiration to start bhakti. They totally changed. So Sukhdeva Goswami was accepted by all Munirishis, everybody, as Bhakti Acharya later on life. Previously, he already confessed in Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavad Gita Mahapurana, Parinishchito Upi Nairgunne. I was interested to take Brahmananda, but later I was changed. But Nirvishesh Gyani, I already told, Hiranyakyo, Hiranyakasubu, Ravan, Virochan, you know, they are, in Jarasandha, they are Nirvishesh Gyani, because they are not going to believe that Nitya Sarupa Bhagavan, Nitya Sarupa Bhakti, nothing. But still, they are doing all Jagya, everything they are doing, Puja, everything they are doing, but they don't They don't believe Vishnu is eternal Sarup. They used to obey Nirvishesh Brahma, impersonal Brahma. They used to Nirvishesh Brahma, this kind of bhavana is typical, impossible. I already told from Gita, abhyaktehi gatir duksham deho vadbhi rabapati. This kind of feeling is impossible. It's very typical because you cannot concentrate your mind into a vacant place. Because for infinity beyond the jivatma, they are habituated to see some shape and design, everything. But at present, if you are forcefully trying to consider an impersonal Brahma, it's impossible. Savishesh Gani, Navadavakti Ashraya Pasadhan Thakire, if they are going, Savishesh Gani, those are Nirvishesh Gani, they are hopeless. They are hopeless. Mahaprabhu speaking, Mayavadi Hoy Krishna Charana Aparadi. They are great offender under the lotus feet of Krishna, because they don't believe the eternal existence of Dhamma, Nama, Sarupa, devotees, devotion, not at all. But Savishesh Bhakta, when they are going to take the help of nine folds of bhakti under, you know, with the association of pure devotees, dire dire, gradually they can get bhakti. That's why Bhagavan told in this sloka, Brahma Bhutaha Prasanyatma Nasachati Nakankati Samaha Sarveshu Bhuteshu Madhbhakti Madhbhaktim Lavatim Param. They can get bhakti someday by the association of pure devotees, by the association of my devotees, someday they can get bhakti. So this way, actually, Savishesh Gani can take the help of nine folds of devotion, and gradually by the association of devotees, they can get. Gyanmissa Bhakti Gyanan, here is predominating factor is Gyan. Not Bhakti is the main. That's why Mahaprabhu told it is external. You have to speak more. So now, Rai Ramananda could realize Mahaprabhu is less interested to hear anything contaminated, anything, you know, mixed tattva. By now, Rai Mahasa, I could realize that Mahaprabhu is not at all interested to hear anything mixed tattva. Mahaprabhu like to hear pure tattva. That's why Gyanisya Bhakti not taken into consideration, not taken into consideration fully by Mahaprabhu. It is external. Now Rai Mahasa is speaking, Rai kahe gyan sunna bhakti shaddosha. When Rai Mahasa is going to explain Prabhu, then gyan sunna bhakti, there is no gyan sunna. Gyan sunna bhakti is shaddosha. When Rai Mahasa, it is very vital, you know. As a sadhana bhakti, it is a very vital thing. Gyan sunna bhakti saddhosa rupe Rai Ramananto, when told in front of Mahaprabhu, then Mahaprabhu was a little bit satisfied. Okay, eho hoy age kohoar. Mahaprabhu said, it is okay, but still, I like to hear more details. More details, you will have to go ahead. So you see, still Mahaprabhu is not totally satisfied. Though Mahaprabhu is again going to grant it, going to accept it, okay. It is okay. Gyan sunna bhakti doesn't mean there is no knowledge. So it is saddha tatte madhyavarti ahoy. Now it is almost going to get entry into pure devotional field. Saddha tattva madhyavarti. Different kind of saddha tattva. Now it is almost in the middle. Saddha tattva, different kind you are explaining, it is almost in the middle. Now it's okay. But I like to hear more details. Then Gyan sunna bhakti Mahaprabhu accept it. Okay. Sikar go, it's okay. Gyan Sunna Bhakti doesn't mean that there is ignorance. Gyan Sunna Bhakti doesn't mean aggo, so they are foolish and murka. They can do. Gyan Sunna, devoid of knowledge, not there. It is not, this meaning is not there. Gyan Sunna Bhakti doesn't mean that some foolish idiot and those who are, you know, ignorant, they can do. Not that. This meaning is not acceptable. Gyan Sunna Bhakti means when sadhak going to avoid the contamination of Gyan with Bhakti. Like previously Gyan Mishra Bhakti. When sadhak going to avoid the contamination of Gyan with Bhakti, that type of Gyan Mishra Bhav, I mean Gyan is there, filling a predominating factor, and Bhakti little bit contaminated, little bit there, mixed. This kind of Bhav when going to throw out, that is called Gyan Sunna Bhakti. Gyan Sunna Bhakti doesn't mean some foolish can do who is having no knowledge, nothing, not that. It means previously the feeling of Gyan Mishra should be avoided. When sadhak going to avoid the feeling of Gyan Mishra Bhava, then that is called Gyan Sunna Bhakti. Actually, to develop detachment, you will have to follow Gyan, because you have to think, this my body is material, this worldly things, this is material world, unstable, anytime I can go away, this is nothing, this is Maya, this kind of, you know, those who are running in the way of Ganmar, they will have to develop their Vairagya that way. But when somebody, by the mercy of pure Bhakti Acharya, pure Bhakta Acharya, going to get Kripa, then he need not feel this way. But in Ganimark, Ganmark also, thought and athought. It is not that, not that, not that, you will have to and eliminate. You can go on eliminating. Tadbastu, atadbastu. No, it is atadbastu. It is not tadbastu. So I must avoid it. This kind of thought and atadbastu, you'll have to eliminate. You know, not to come within the area of influence of Maya, not to come within the area of the influence of Maya, you know, it is very typical. So you have to practice Gyan. In that case, Maya cannot touch you. This way you are trying. That's why those who are following Gyan mark, their mark is not so easy. They can come out successful, there is no such guarantee. That's why in the beginning I was bound to give this example of, you know, by Prabhupada give this example, the baby, you know, deer, you know, there is a cat baby and monkey baby, I already give example. So in Ganmarg you will have to eliminate. It is atat, niroshan. It is not good, it is not that. It is atat bastu. It is not tadbastu. In this kind of exercise, you will have to practice. And the moment you are going to lose your way, you can, even there is no guarantee. Gyan Mishra Bhakti te krama marg in gradual way. In Gyan Mishra Bhakti marg, in gradual course of promotion, you can get chance to get bhakti. But if those who are following only, you know, keval Gyan, Kevala, again, it is dangerous. Because those who are doing Hariseva, for them it is not a problem. When somebody is going to start Hariseva, then automatically, even though you are practicing, still then, you cannot feel so much problem. Because you are busy with Navida Bhakti, you are hearing Harikatha, you are speaking Harikatha, you are meditating on the lotus feet of Harikatha, you are, you know. This way, those who are engaged in Hari Bhajan, for them it is very easy because they cannot feel any influence of body and mind. When you are doing bhakti, then if there is continuous in Nirantaragilana, then when you are trying to do continuous devotional practice, Niranta, in that case, automatically you are not going to feel any problem because your body, mind, everything, all going to change. Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat Deho Dehi Kavisrite, this slogan you should remember, given by Sri Sanatana Goswami in Brihad Bhagavatam. Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat Deho Dehi Kavisrite. Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat, when you are going to practice, you know, Sudha Pan, Krishna Bhakti Ras, from right source, you are going to hear. Okay, then Sanatana Goswami speaking, Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat Deho Dehi Kavisrite. Then you cannot remember your body and body related thing, your belongings, you cannot remember. Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat Deho Dehi Kavisrite. Tesam panchabhautik dehopi sachyananda rupata. This is a very high thing. This is very high thing. But first, you know, to prove it, that those who are continuously doing Hari Bhajan, Hari Katha, hearing Hari Katha, chanting Hari Katha, Hari Nam, continuously doing Hari Seva, so automatically you are going to lose your connection with matter and Maya. Matter means Maya also. There is no influence. You cannot feel. You cannot feel any pressure of body, mind, everything is automatically, you know. So, sabda, sparsha, rup, ras, gandha, anyway, not going to put you in trouble. You are not feeling attraction because aprakita hari and his rupa, guna, lam, lila, vishuddha, pure. So, you are going to feel that. Satchit, ananda, sarup, bhagavan, you are going to feeling something about him. In front of that aprakita ananda, material ananda is nothing. In front of that aprakita ananda, this ananda, material enjoyment is nothing. Big, big jnani, maha, maha jnani, yogi, you know, they were also attracted by the beauty of a woman. Many such cases happen. Mahamagyani, Durvasavini Mahagyani, Vasishtamuni Mahagyani, you know, Vishwamitra Muni, they are Mahagyani. Mahamagyani Yogigan, they are also somehow their yoga was, you know, but when Nara Narayan, they are doing bhajan in Badri Narayan Khetra. Nara Narayan, they are not ordinary men, they are Bhagavan. When Nara Narayan doing bhajan, they are still today, their astuti and finance, they are doing for the total benefit of common people. Jagatvasi Mangala Janno. In that case, we know Naranaran, you see, when doing bhajan, then Indra Maharaj going to send Apsara to disturb them both. Apsara coming with full troops, you know. Indra Maharaj going to send them, you know, dancing, you know, changing the climate so that somebody can feel some karma inside her. This way they are trying their best, playing on musical instruments, singing very nice way, and dancing. Those apsaras, they are dancing in such a mood that nobody can stop attraction. So it's quite natural. In that case, we see Nara Narayan, when going to open eyes to look at that Prakito Kamdev. Prakito Kamdev was given responsibility by Indra Maharaj. Prakito Kamdev, material Kamdev, was given responsibility. Material Kamdev, Jado Kamdev, was given responsibility by Indra to disturb and break their astridian finances, because Indra Maharaj was thinking, fearing, that maybe they can take over my seat. So, before that, I must arrange such a situation so that they can break their astridian finances and I can come out successful in my effort. Because I like to stay as a king. You know, Indra Maharaj singing that way, going to send Prakita Kamdev and all those Apsara, Tilottama, Adi, they all going to dance there in Himalaya hills in front of Naranarayan, where they were busy to do tapasya, I mean austerity penances. But it was just opposite. When Naranarayan going to open eyes, then they are very afraid. When Naranarayan going to open their eyes and going to look at Apsara and those who are dancing everything, but they become frightened, they become very fearful. Because Naranarayan not feeling any attraction, and they fearing because we have done some aparad. They are doing astridian penances, we come here to disturb them. So naturally they are feeling, you know, this way, negative feeling. Maybe we have done some aparad. Naranarayan actually, Narayan, they are going to, you know, they are going to make so many apsara from their body. From their transcendental body, they are going to, you know, make apsara. Topmost apsara in the heaven, who? You know already. That apsara was created by Narayanas as a gift to Indra Maharaj. Indra Maharaj can take these, you know. So, they are doing austerity penances, nobody can disturb them. But Mahamahagyani Purush, they feeling disturbance. They are feeling disturbance. Mahamahagyani, they break their, we know. But we know that Ramdas, Hanumanji Maharaj are not going to feel any disturbance. Thousands of, you know, beautiful ladies going to make disturbance. But Hanumanji Maharaj was busy with his seva of Ramji. And also Haridas Thakur, many times he was tested. Mayadevi herself came. Mayadevi herself came in Fulia. Lakshaidya also came to make disturbance. But they all got defeated by Haridas Thakur. And Haridas Thakur was bound to give kipa to them. Mayadevi also took Mahamantra from Haridas Thakur. And Lakshmi Hira also, you know, got mantra from Haridas Thakur. This way we find that those who are going to get the taste of Harinam, because when you are going to get the taste of Harinam, like Mahaprabhu wanted to see this way, you know, Mahaprabhu always wanted to see this way, that if you can get the, you know, facility to chant pure Harinam, that Rupa Goswami also wanted to speak. Yad Brahma Shakshat Kriti. Even he is having the feeling of Brahmananda. Yad Brahma Shakshat Kriti Nishthayapi. He is having, you know, Nishtha affinity. Yad Brahma Shakshat Kriti Nishthayapi. Bina Samayati Binana. Without, you know, getting the result of karma fall, pleasure and pain. Yad Brahma Sakshat Kirtin Sri Vinasa Mayati Vinana Bhoga. So long as they are not going to cut Maya totally, so long as they are not solved, so long as they are not successful to cut Maya totally by the help of Harinam, then they are not successful. Yad Brahma Sakshat Kirtin Sri Yapi Vinasa Mayati Vinana Bhoga. Apaiti nam of Spuranena Tatte, with total Tatta of Harinam. When somebody can realize Nam Tatta and going to do Harinam, chant Harinam, Kitinisa, Vinasa Mayati Vinana Bhogoi. You know, without suffering, without, you know, karmaphal can come in the pain and pleasure. Pain and pleasure, different form. Sometimes in the mood of enjoyment can come in your life. Your activity is result of your activity, sometimes pain. So, Rupa Goswami is speaking, Yad Brahma Sakshat Kirtin Shreyapi, Bina Samayati Vinana Bhogai, without accepting the result of their karma fall, there is no respite. But, Apaiti nama spuranena tatte. When somehow by the mercy of Nam Prabhu as Hari Guru Vaishnava, somehow apaiti nama spuranena tatte, with full tatta, Harinam Prabhu going to give kiva, apaiti nama spuranena tatte, parabdha karmeti viroti vedha. Then they are not going to suffer any of their parabdha. Arabdha, their previous karma fall, not coming in their life as a result. Because they can go out of the result of any karma fall. Karma fall not going to put them in trouble anymore. So you see, Mahamahagyani, they also fall down many times, whereas we find Ramdas, Hanumanji, Krishnadas, you know, Haridas Thakur, they are all successful. They are not going to feel any attraction. This way, so Keval Bhakti, those who are going to take help of only Bhakti, no mixing procedure, Gyanshunna Bhakti. That is why Keval Bhakti, Jog Ashraykari Bhaktir Kono Karma Gyanera Jog. Actually, those who are going to take shelter of bhakti solely, totally, they need not play their head over what kind of problem can happen. Because they are going to cut connection with Gyan, Karma, mode, anything. They cannot. That is why Mahaprabhu told it is okay. Then in that case, Mahaprabhu wanted to hear scriptural evidence, that you can give one example so that we can realize. Then Raya Mahasaya was bound to speak the sloka from 10th canto. Gyane prayasa mudapasya namant eva jivanti sanmukha ritam bhavadiya vartam sthane sthitaha sutigatam tonubhag manavir je prayaso ajito jito piyosi tvaistri lokyam. That the effort of Jnana totally thrown out. It is a sloka spoken by Brahma. Brahma Stuti. Brahma speaking in front of Supreme Lord, Jnane prayasa mudapasya, I am going to throw the effort of Jnana. Anyway, I am not going to take the help of Jnana. Jnane prayasa mudapasya namanta eva. And how you can live? Jivantis sanmukharitam bhavadiya vartam. I like to hear all Harikatha, Nectarian Harikatha coming out from the lotus mouth of your devotees. Jivanti Sanmukharitam, Satmani Sadhu, Sanmukharitam, Sanmukho Iritam, Iritam means Gitam, Satmani Sadhu. So, Sanmukharitam Bhavadiyavata, Bhavadiyavani, your glories, you know, name, fame, you know, Leela, different kind of, dham, nam, everything. So Gyane Prayaso Mudavasa Namantaeva Jivanti San Sat Mukhari San Mukharitam Bhavadiyavartam. And I like to stay in front of sadhu always, because if I stay continuously with sadhu mentally or physically, then Maya cannot touch you. Maya going to touch you because you cannot stay continuously in front of a sadhu mentally. Physically, if not possible, mentally at least. So sthane sthita, this means Vishwanath Chakur speaking, sthane sthita meaning in front of sadhu I like to stay, because sadhu means always can speak harikatha. Satang prasangad mama virja sangvido bhavanti hitkarna rasayana katha tadjoshanat ashu apavarga vatmani shadhya ratir shadhya bhakti rati ranukramishyati. It is gradual promotional procedure. So actually, gane prayasa mudabhasya namanteva jivanti sanmukharitam bhavadiya vartam. Sthane sthane sthita mani in front of sadhu I like to stay all the time. All the sutigatam, sthane sthita sutigatam, and a sutigatam mani sruti mean, one name of sruti is Veda, but here meaning is sutigatam. I can allow my ear, oral reception. Here sutigatam mean oral reception. This device given by Supreme Lord. Oral reception power is there with eyes. So sutigatam means I can allow my ear to drink that nectar coming from the lotus mouth of Supreme Lord. Sutigatam. And how? What is the procedure? Tonubang manovir. Tonubang kaya manvakya. By body, speech and mind, I can show submission unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. Sthane sthitaha sutigatam tanubhag manovhir. Those who are going to follow this procedure only, for them, sthane sthitaha sutigatam tanubhag manovhir je prayoso. You know, ajito, you cannot be conquered. Your name is Ajit. You can never be conquered by anybody. But sthane sthitaha sutigatam tanubhag manovhir je prayaso usually cannot conquer you know, but they can conquer you very easily. You can be conquered by them. Prayaso ajito jito pyoshi, you become conquered by them. Etrailokyam, they are going to, you know, conquer you out of their love. So now, different acharyas going to explain in different way of this sloka. Siddha Saipat, Jiva Goswamipat, Sri Sudarshan Suri, Sri Bir Raghavji Maharaj, Sri Nivas Suri, Sri Vallava Acharya, Sri Giridhari Lal, Sri Vishwanath Chakravarti, all their Sanatana Goswami, all different way they are going to explain. So overall explanation I already told you. Gane prayasa mudabhasso, this Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking. Udo pasyo ishad opi kritva arthat gane prayasa manavadi ishad. There I cannot allow any space, any provision inside my mind. You know, my mind, there cannot be any smell of any, you know, knowledgeful effort. No, I cannot. So Siddha Swami was speaking, Udo Pasho Ishad Opi Kritva, Ishad Opi Akritva. That's mean, Bhagavan, I am not going to give any place of the, you know, any, you know, value of jnana inside my heart. I am going to clean it totally. Srila Jiva Goswami was speaking, Gyani Todiyo Sarupai Sarjo Mahima Vicharaha. You know, Gyani Prayasa Mudabhasa means the material gyan I can throw, and I can go on thinking about Sarup. Sarupai Sarjo Mahima Vichar. In that case, automatically, because mind can never go back and only I can exchange, you know, alternative thing. Gyani isthale ta sarubhajam, you know, Jiva Goswami is speaking, Gyani tadyo sarupaisarjo mahima vicharo, you know, this kind of aisarjo gyan sarup vichar, you know, we are going to leave it and only going to want to develop a loveful relation with you. Keval pranay bhare bhajan, only doing to, like to do bhajan out of loveful mood, loveful attitude. Only and only then you can be conquered. Without love, you can never be conquered. Now we cannot explain so much. Viswanath Chakravarti speaking, Nonu tarhi tameva viditva oti mrtum eti. In a suti, Nonu tarhi tameva viditva oti mrtum eti. It is Shruti. When we can know this information from Shruti, and then we can avoid mrtyu. Mrtyu means death. When you are going to get amrita, no question of mrtyu. That's why when Sukadeva Goswami going to stop Harikatha and going away, then speaking, Rajan, you are going to die, this kind of foolish conception should be thrown away. But when started giving Bhagavat, you know, explanation, in the beginning, Parikshit Maharaj, Sukadeva Goswami is bound to speak that, Tam tu marishye Rajan, you are going to die, Rajan, you will have to remember all the time. Tam tu marishye, you know, Tam tu marishye iti achintvayo. Continuously go on thinking that you are going to die. I am going to die. I am going to die. I am going to die. You have to think repeatedly. So automatically, detachment can develop inside your heart if you can get this kind of feeling. Tam tu marishye iti achintvayo. Go on thinking about it. But when Harikatha was over totally, when Sukadeva Goswami going going away from that place and blessing Parikshit Maharaj, then finally Sukadeva Goswami going to speak in front of Parikshit Maharaj that Rajan, Tam tu marishye, you are going to die, this kind of beastly conception should be thrown away from your mind. Tam tu marishye Pashubuddhi Mimam Jahi. This kind of, because when you are drinking the nectarian Harikatha, Bhagavat Katha, then you can realize your Sarup. And if you can realize your Sarup, then there is mrtyu, death cannot touch you. Death can touch you when you can realize, we cannot realize Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan. That is why Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking. When you are going to get this advice from Shruti, naturally you can get rid of mrtyu, death. You know, death sentence is already there, given by Vidhata, according to our karma fall. When we are going to die, we don't know. So, Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking, Gyane Presa Mudabhasso Iti, you know, nothing, no effort should be there. When on, there should not be any effort of jnana. You know, nirantar continuously sanmukharitam from, we are going to hear the Nikcharyan Sankirtan from the lotus feet of Guru Islam. Nirantara sanmukharitam uchakirtaner dara. By the help of, you know, Sankirtan, loud Sankirtan. Bhagavan, get defeated. Bhagavan can be conquered by this procedure. Bhagavan can be conquered. Also, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sankirtanaika Pitarau, we know, they are Sankirtan Peta. Especially in this Kali Kal, this procedure is all different Kal. Not that only Kali Kal, especially in this Kali Kal. Sankirtan is the mode of bhajan through which you can satisfy the Supreme Lord, even in Satya Yuga, Teta Yuga, you know, Dapar Yuga, Teta Yuga, or Kali Yuga, but especially in this Kali Yuga. This Kali Yuga. Especially. So we can satisfy you, we can, you know, and you can get defeated by this mood. Sankirtan, Sankirtan. With full loving mood, you can do Sankirtan this way. So this way, Namanta, I already explained before starting explaining this thing. Because Namanta means you will have to leave your Ahankar. Sannyas is not a matter of joke. Totally you will have to leave Ahankar, Abhiman, false ego. You will have to clean Abhiman from your heart. Like the example of Tirandi Bhikshuk from Bhagavatam is the exact example. But your sannyas, maybe it is not perfect sannyas. Who can say? So, if it is at all perfect sannyas, then why different kind of, you know, material thing going to influence you? Maya going to influence you? Tirandi Bhikshuk is going to take sannyas, but everybody going to insult him, snatch away his kamandul, water pot, everything, danda, but still he is not going to express angry attitude. Because he is going to feel from heart everything and anything and everything done by Supreme Lord. Directly, indirectly, everything can be done by Supreme Lord. So Tidandi Sannyas Bhikkhuk. Tidandi Bhikkhuk, this example is right example. Tirandi Bhikkhuk, the example is right example. All other, you know, everybody taking sannyas, not the sannyas. You know, geyoho sa nitya sannyasi jo no adeshti no kankati. This kind of condition you cannot fulfill. You can fulfill. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, even external sannyas is not there. Still the vital condition there. Gyanhosi sa nitya sannyasi. He is eternal sannyas. Jono destino kankati. Who is not going to show any violence, nothing, always going to show mercy to everybody. Kankati. Kankati means no expectation there. If there is no expectation, then there is no karma. If there is no karma, there is no krodha. If there is no krodha, there is no violence attitude. It's interrelated. Dayato vishana pungsam sangaste supajayate sangyat sangyate kamaha kamat krodha avijayate krodhat bhavati sanmoho sanmohat siti vibhvam sat buddhinaso buddhinasat pranasan. This way, Vishwanath Chakradeva is speaking, that with full mood of Sankirtan, loveful mood, if you can do, then Supreme Lord can be conquered very easily by the devotee. Also, Sanatana Goswami Path, Brihad Vaishnav Tasani, is writing, Tato yatha kathanchit tavo bhajaneno tvam vasik kriyam ityaha ata hari bhajane. Sanatana Goswami speaking, it is not 100% necessary that you will have to go through different shastra to develop knowledge and then and only then you can start bhakti, not that. Even savari, without having knowledge of shastra gyan, externally you can find our Gaur Kishore Baba is not externally, you can internally there. So Sanatana Goswami was Sanatan Goswami was speaking, it is not necessary. Then in the way of your bhajan, you will have to collect all gan, etc., everything. Not that. But he is Bhagavan Supreme Lord, you know, feel satisfaction because of your, you know, pure devotion. You know, because of your pure devotion, then he can feel satisfaction. Not only, you know, gan is not such an important thing. But gan means actually, after when you are doing bhajan, no, actually, annavilasita sunyam jnana karmadi anabritam. This means actually, jnana karmadi anabritam, jnana you will have to, jnana karmadi anabritam. You know, first of all, annavilasita sunyam. There should not be any annavilas, any kind of desire. Annavilasita sunyam and gone jnana karmadi anabritam. That means, that kind of knowledge which is helpful to develop your bhakti is positive. That's why Rupa Goswami was writing Annavilasita Sunyam, but Jnana Karmadi not Sunyam. Sunyam means zero. Vishwanath, actually, Rupa Goswami is speaking, the Annavilasita, there should not be any space of Annavilasita. Annavilasita Sunyam. But Jnana Karmadi Anabritam. Jnana Ebang Karma Jnana Karmadi Anabritam. Not Sunyam. Anabritam means uncovered. Not going to cover my Chetana. When Jnana Ebang Karma going to cover up my Chetana, going to stop my devotion, then it is prohibited. Jnana Karmadi Anabritam means that kind of positive knowledge. How to do bhakti, this kind of positive knowledge is not prohibited. And karma means when a devotee going to cook, going to offer, this is also karma, but this kind of karma is not prohibited. That's why devotional karma is allowed. So, annavilasita sunnam jnana karmadi anabritam, and after that another point, anukullena krishna anusilana. It should be anukula, favorable. It's very important. And there's long discussion actually. Our Gauriya Guru Varga speaking, Anukula is only Radharani, is, you know, Radharani's mood is favorable for Krishna. Anukulena Krishna Anusilan means you will have to follow Radharani, Brajabadu Vargena Jakilpita. I mean, finally, you will have to follow Radharani to understand the mood of your bhajan, and which can give full satisfaction to Supreme Lord. So, namanto eva de sthane sthita tonubhag manave, already I explained everything. Je prayaso ajito bijito bistoiste. Hey Ajit, you can be easily conquered by such devotees. Those who are going to follow this procedure, this much. I cannot explain more, no, it will take time. Because Bhagavan is Ajit. Bhagavan can never be conquered by anybody in this 14th world. But those devotees, they can conquer him. There is a meaning. Then after that, Actually, Rai Ramananda Mahasaya is going to give another example from Bhagavatam to give the evidence that bhakti, Bhagavan becomes satisfied only with bhakti. Prayena bhakti yogena satsangena vinodbhava no upayo vidyate sadram prayanam his satamaham. Ho Uddhav, I am the ultimate shelter of the sadhu, pure sadhu. Satsanga uttrita bhakti, out of pure satsanga, the kind of bhakti you are getting, only this can subjugate me, it can control me. I can be controlled by those sadhu, you know, not by others. He Uddhava, try to understand. Aham bhakto praparadhino, hi asatantra ivadhiya. I can get controlled by my devotee. In front of Uddhava, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, prayena bhakti yogena satsangena vinudbha no payo. There is no alternative except this. What is this? Except the kind of devotion you can expect from out of your pure association. This kind of bhakti only can melt me, my heart. Krishna speaking. Other kind of efforts, not so effective. Prayena bhakti yogena satsangena vina uddha. No payo, there is no alternative. Vidyate, chadram, pranam his satamaham. Those pure sadhu, they are going to show bhakti mood, and those going to, like, I can give the example of Naradji Maharaj in his previous life, Sadhan Siddha Narad. This Naradji Maharaj, at the time of Chaturmasa Vrata, he was hearing Harikatha, doing Kirtan with them, taking Uchishta, everything from them in their village. They actually, Naraji Maharaj, it is written, my heart was melted. I don't know why. After hearing the Harikatha, different kind of Kirtan they are doing, someday also they give me Uchishta Prasadam. And it is written in Bhagavatam, Sakitsma bhunje tadabhast kilvishaha. When Sankirtan, Harikatha Kirtan going to cut my anartha, also one day, when they going to give me Uchishta Prasadam, then, you know, one time when I get total my anartha clear. Naraji Maharaj going to speak about his previous in front of Vyasadevji Maharaj. So Uddhav, try to understand Ashtanga Yoga, Sankhya Tattva, Varnasram, Dharmacharan, Shadvai, Veda, Sruti, Adhyayan, Tapasya, Tag, Ishta, Purti, Dakshina, Donation, and different kind of Vratanushtan, in a bow. Yajnanushtan, Shastrapat, Tirtha Snan, taking bath in Tirtha, pilgrimage, different kind of rules and regulation, Niyam, Jam. Nobody can subjugate me, nobody can control me. Only I can be controlled by Priti, Lava. Only, though I know, only I can be controlled by Prema, Lava, Lava. Priti. So, if you are going to get that kind of bhakti by the association of pure devotees, and if you are going to do that kind of bhakti, priti, because sangha, the kind of sangha you are doing, you are going to get benefit. If you are going to do kapat sangha, then you are not going to get result. Otherwise, Jiva Goswami is speaking, it is inevitable. Sangha, the result of Sangha, any kind of Sangha, be it bad Sangha, asasangha, sasangha, you will have to take the share, suffer. The kind of Sangha you are doing, you will have to get that type of result. So, Sangha is a must. You cannot avoid. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, Sangha is the root cause of developing your character, behavior. Sangha is Shabhavir mood, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking in an article. So, actually, that type of bhakti, what you are going to get from pure devotees who are doing Nam Sankirtan and everything, pure devotees, that satsanga can give you chance to get that kind of bhakti which can give me satisfaction. I can be controlled by that bhakti, prema. Trasto Vittasur Narod Angira Muni Sangha Prabhupada, actually we can find from Bhagavatam one slok. Also long ago, I already discussed it, but still the situation now, you know, can demand this slok as explanation. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking that Bahavo Matpadam Prapta Trashta Kaya Dhavadayo Vrishaparva Balirvano Mayaschata Vivishanaha Sugriva Hunimana Niksho Gajo Griddha Panika Patha Vyadaha Kubja Braje Goppo Yogyo Patnaha Stathapare. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Uddhava. You know, 11th canto, 12th chapter, 5. Bahobo matpadam prapta trashta kaya dhavadayo vrishaparvabalirbhano mayaschatho vibhishanah sugriva hanuman nikshyo gajo griddho paniko patho vyadha kubja vraje gappo yagya patnah stathapari tena adhita srutigana No pasita mahatamaha aprata tapta tapasa satsangyat mam upagataha te nadito srutigana no pasita mahatamaha aprata tapta tapasa satsangyat mam upagataha. Those are the examples. Bahavo, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, you see, Bibhishan, Sugrip, Vibhishana Sugrip, Hanuman Sangha Prabhav. Jambuban, Gajo, Griddho, Gajo, Gajo means Gajendra, Gajo, Griddho, Jatayu, Griddho means Jatayu. You know, Banik, that businessman finally got bhakti, Tirandi Swami. Baniko, Vyadha, Vyad was changed by the help of Naraji Maharaj. Vyadha, Kubja, you know, Kubja in Mathura. Gopigan, all Gopika, all Gopis, you know, Gopi, oh, Jagapatni. And I already explained, you can remember. Jagapatni. Jagapatni, those who are the wives of Jagik Patni, they also, all you can analytically you can see, they are going to satisfy Supreme Lord only by the means of satsanga. No other. Only by the means of satsanga, by the help of satsanga, they are getting that kind of mood of bhajan. To satisfy Supreme Lord, not only, but also they were successful to get the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. That's why Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Bahavo Matpadam Prapta Trashto Kaya Dhavadayoho Prahlad Brisho Parva Sura Prahlad Sangha, you know, Kayadu Prahlad Naraji Muni. Sangha, Trasto, Vrittasur, Sri Narada Mangira, Sangha, Association. Bali Maharaj by the Association of Prahlad Maharaj. Banasur by the Sangha, Association of Sivji Maharaj. Vibhishana Sugrip, you know, Hanuman Sangha. This way, and those Jagyik Patni by the Association of this Malini. See, Malini was, you know, she used to sing the glories of Krishna. She was very poor lady. She used to collect flowers from in a forest and sell in the market. So Malini, so how they can go bhakti? By the association of Malini, the Jagyik Patni, all the wives of Jagyik Brahman, they got bhakti. Bahavo Matpadam Prapta Trashto kaya dhavadayo Vrishaparabhavalir bhano Mayaschatho vivishana Sugriva hanuman riksho Gajo griddho baniko pataha Vyadaho kubja braje goppo Yagyo patna stathapare Te nadhito sutigana no pasito mahatama Abrata tapta tapaso satsangyatmam upagataha. Only by the means of satsangadeva. They never been in Gurukul. Te nadhito sutiganaha. They never read Shruti, Veda. They never been in the house of, you know, Gurukul. Te nadhito sutigana no pasito mahatamaha. No, they are not going to serve Guru, you know, this, that. They never took any bow in their life. You know, abhrata tapta tapasam. Abhrata means they never took bow. Brata, different kind of brata to satisfy. And also astridian penance, what you speak about astridian penance. They never took it. Abhrata tapta tapasam. Satsangat, only by the means of satsangat, mam upagataha. They all, you know, were successful to get my lotus feet. Because all brata tapasya, anything, also I explained long ago, you can remember. If Supreme Lord is not satisfied, what I can do with this bow and astudian pronounces, what is use? What use? Useless. Aradhito jadi tapasas tatoskim, naradhito jadi tapasas tatoskim, antar bahir jadi tapasas tatoskim, naantar bahir jadi tapasas tatoskim. Prabhupada used to explain this sloka. Aradhito jadi tapasas tatoskim, if at all Supreme Lord is satisfied, then what I can do? Show business, you know, drama, what I can do? No need. Aradhito, if Supreme Lord is already satisfied with this kind, then what I can do? By opening one market and a shop of exhibition? Aradhito jodi tapasas tatas kim. What I can do with tapasa? And Aradhito jodi tapasa, if Supreme Lord is not satisfied by astridian penances, what I am going to take trouble to do it, what use? Aradhito jodi tapasas tatas kim. Naradhito jodi tapasa, what I can do with that? Antar bahir jodi tapasa, if inside and outside all the time I am going to see this, then the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Antar bahir, all the time I can see Supreme Lord, internally, externally, everywhere, every time, non-stop. Om Tad Vishnum Paramam Padam Sada Pashvanti Surayo Divivo Chakshuratatam Atatam. Atatam means to those Rishi Manis, the Pashuris, they can know past, present and future. They are going to open their eyes continuously, non-stop. They are going to see the lotus, watching the lotus feet of Vishnu. Om Tad Vishnum Paramam Padam Sada Pashanti Surayo Divivo Chakshuratatam. This is a Rigved mantra. It's from Rigved. So Antar Bahir Jadi Tapasastatuski. They are already thinking about loveful relation with Supreme Lord, always thinking about Supreme Lord. They cannot forget Supreme Lord. Even to forget Supreme Lord is impossible for them. What they can do with tapasya, everything? What they can do? They are not going to open one, one shop exhibition. So antar bahir jodi tapasya satokim, a Supreme Lord is already present there inside, outside all the time. What I can do? And no antar bahir jodi, if anyway after hearing Harikatha, hearing so many things, doing so many astudian penance, everything I am doing, but I cannot see Supreme Lord, not Even inside, outside, nowhere I can see. I cannot feel. When you are going to do Gayatri Mantra Jagya, when you are going to come Gayatri, if you cannot see, you know, you need not go to Jagannath temple. You can clearly see Jagannath sitting on throne, you know, all with full decoration, even cloth you can see, everything, all decoration, golden ornament, everything, legs and all. Provided you are going to get the full kippa of Bhakti Devi. Bhakti Devi, if you are going to get the full kippa of Bhakti Devi, Nikcharyan, then sure you cannot forget Supreme Lord. So when you are going to do, you know, when you are going to do Astiri and Pinas, what use? Tapasas Tatoski, Nantar Bhajyati. So what is the outcome? You have to do perfect bhakti as shown by Raya Ramananda Mahasaya. This is the procedure. Raya Ramananda going to quote this sloka to prove in favor. Now Mahaprabhu then finally speaking, Gansunna Bhakti, it's okay, but still you have to go further, you have to go in deep. Then ultimately Raya Mahasaya was bound to speak about Prem Bhakti Sarva Dharma Sar. Raya Mahasaya was bound to speak about Prem Bhakti Sarva Sadhya Sar, all different kind of mode of sad, you know, sadhana, you know, Sadhya Sar, Prem Bhakti. Sadhya Sar means through your bhajan you will have to get Prem Bhakti. Sadhya Sar, not Sadhan Sar. You know, previously I was discussing about, you know, Sadhan Tattva Sarup Lakhan. But now here I am also saying that through your sadhan should go such a way so that you can get Prem Bhakti. So, Sarbo Sadhya Sar, final outcome of your sadhan should be Prem Bhakti. Mahaprabhu was happy. So Raya Mahasaya was bound to speak Prem Bhakti Sarva Sadhya Sar. Then there is three kind of bhakti we know. Again we let analytical judgment should be there. Tomorrow we can do. Sadhan Bhakti, Bhav Bhakti, Prem Bhakti. Which bhakti you mean? Anyway, Sadhan Bhakti, Bhav Bhakti, Prem Bhakti. Sadhan Bhakti, explanation under the guidance of Rupa Goswami Pad. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Jiva Goswami, you can do Kriti Shaddo Yabhavaha, this sloka. Kriti Shaddo Bhavet, Shaddo Bhava, Sa Sadharavida. Nitto Siddhasya Bhavasya Prakattam Hidi Shaddhata. This explanation I can do tomorrow, not today. Actually, you can get confused. So, gradually try to understand. Gradually try to understand this mood, you know. So, Yad Brahma Shakshad Kitinishayapi Bina Savayati Bina Nabhogai Apaiti Namo Spurane Natati Parabdha Karameti Virauti Vedaha Vanchakalpatrosi Kepasindhu Vavisha Patitanang Pavana Bhavishna Vyo Namo.